right, my
headphones. The Gemini Music Group.
Mine either.
Oh, we're gonna keep all that too, man.
Oh, there we go.
Headphone volume good.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, we started.
Good, you know what I'm saying? And we are back with another episode of the I Said Yerrr.
Oh, it's 41, ain't it?
41.
Damn.
You know what I mean? Let's bring it in with some freaking music real quick though. You know, start off with little tunes from Ace Hood, new track Energy. Well, I thought one of y'all lighting the lighter.
What's up, man? Up, the king is here, my ride, well, it's right on time. And if you do not mind, I like a glass of Prosecco wine. I'm with the queen, finna get off line. Wait, scratch that. I'm fly like the jet lag. I'm proof in the fact you can rise from the setback. No room for the chit chat. With a flow like this, shit hit with an impact. How you do it? I don't get that. He a father, artist, man, and a good dad. Real nigga to the core, and I meant that. 10 toes when I'm on, you offend that. Sorry, I done made peace for deposits. Spending my days in the silence. I can hear a voice, I can hear the voice of the goddess. And you gotta watch your surroundings. Protect your
energy. Ooh. Energy. Ooh. Energy, ooh, energy, ooh, energy, ooh, energy, ooh, energy, ooh, energy, ooh, flow, ooh, flow, ooh, flow, ooh, flow, ooh, go, ooh, go, ooh, go,
go. Best in the bunch, with a cool rage from the dungeon. Still come through in the clutch. I'm that dime in the dozen, filling up clean to the function. Niggas mislead with assumptions. Gotta stay clean from the grudges. Niggas getting way too comfortable. Young men fresh from the jump back. Energy feeling like contact. Kiss that. Hit him up, double right back. Still dope dealing on wax. Nigga black don't crack. I still get the feeling I'm net. I need more space for the packs. No ceiling, no cap. Running shit's feeling like Jackson. The move from the clay like cash. The shit too massive for your mind to imagine. We're from sleeping on flows to be putting in codes to get an entry to the castle. I've been reaching my goals. I've been minding my own. And I found me your wife who can match it. Never mind who was hating. I'm way too brave. And I'm living on pure elevation. Vision, vision.
Energy, ooh, energy, ooh, energy, ooh, energy, ooh, energy, ooh, energy, ooh, energy.
What is this again? What is this again? I say yeah. Oh, you a little late. She's late. Nah, she's late. She's we'll late. Yeah, you got to do it again, man. What is this again?
I say yeah.
You know what I mean? Episode 41. Shout out to the first time listeners, the last time listeners, the all time listeners. We appreciate your viewership and your listenership. Mm-hmm. You feel what I'm saying? We made it this far. You feel what I'm saying? We close to a year, too.
Already?
Yeah.
When we kick this off?
I think, was it July? No, August.
August.
The first week of August, I think. I don't know. I got to look back at the archives. You feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But yeah, man. First week on, you know, almost 1 year. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah, we live too. So I know, you know what I mean? We live. You want to share and join, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But we got a guest with us tonight. You feel what I'm saying? First time on the I Said Yerrr. You know what I mean? Not her first time at Gemini Music Group Studio, but the first time when I Said Yerrr, she was seen on Fluffy Leisha podcast. You know what I'm saying? With Fluffy Nay and Leisha, you know what I'm saying?
Also on the Lives.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, you was on Lives.
You was fucked up on that Live.
No, I wasn't.
Sure.
I wasn't.
I
wasn't.
Yeah, tell them who you is, you know what I'm saying?
It's your girl, Angel Dominique, in the building.
Yeah, welcome to the I Say Yerrr podcast. You know what I'm saying? Unfortunately, we don't have Boss Jay here with us tonight. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He's I guess he's on daddy duty. You know what I'm saying? That's what he said he was, right?
Yeah, he said he got the kids.
Yeah, he got like 8 of them joints. Mm-hmm. Nah, it's like 5.
Don't do that.
We don't have enough seats for that, so.
Yikes. You feel what I'm saying? I'm trying to figure out how to share the my freaking live video. Yeah, I can't share it. You shared it?
Share it through what, though?
Facebook? Like on your page, and I can go off your page and grab that joint. You know what I'm saying? But we got an eventful pod for y'all tonight, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? So, our guest, though, you know what I'm saying? Angel Dominique, you feel what I'm saying? AKA Beyonce, you know what I'm saying?
I'm always in the middle.
Light skin, you feel what I'm saying?
I mean,
you know what I mean? Oh,
it ain't about that.
I will say, though, light skin people do be on time. They do.
Yo,
be on time.
You said that, and it's crazy because you can ask any of my friends or family, I'm always late.
For real?
Always. I was only 7 minutes late.
Who sang that song? Like, always on time.
Ashanti.
She likes him too, right?
She is.
Yeah, we up in here, you know what I'm saying? So tell us about yourself, you know what I'm saying? Tell us about yourself. Where you from? All that.
Listen,
you know what I mean?
Y'all know me already.
No, we
I
do, but
I know,
you
but
know what
even
mean?
the folk, like, you know, this ain't my first time, you know, around here at the rodeo with y'all.
Nah, you gotta remember though, we got different folks though.
You know I know, but you know
our folks are classy. You know what I mean? Our folks go to Target, they just go to Walmart. You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
Oh man, what can I say, man?
You from Delaware?
I am, born and raised. Shout out to Belvedere. That's where I'm from. Born and raised in Belvedere. Yeah, definitely. Shit, I don't know. I don't even know what to tell y'all because I feel like, you know what I mean.
That's cool. We about to put it all out there. So
what? Ask a question. I don't know. No, shit.
You about to show yourself. So this is how we do it.
Yeah, like I don't know what y'all want to know. When the alcohol kick in?
Well, nah, it's also, you know, the way we handle these topics and shit.
Okay, well, yeah.
That's the real introduction.
I'm the devil's advocate. I'm always the devil's advocate, so I will give you that. So I may have, like, you know, you'll say it one way, and I'll be like, but wait. Let's look at it this way, you know what I mean? So, I don't know, we gonna say it. Let's have fun.
That's what we're here for.
Well, shoot, let's get into this first topic then, you know what I'm saying?
Let's
so, my freaking, all right, so the Carnival Cruise, right?
I'm trying to do a cruise.
Carnival?
A cruise.
You been on a cruise before?
Nah.
Me either.
After this, I'm going. I did want to do Carnival, but I'm definitely doing Norwegian now.
You been on a cruise before?
Nah.
Okay, so the last time our people got on a boat, it didn't end up too well.
It wasn't willingly.
It was not, okay? So why would I pay to get on another? Listen, I don't know. I'm cool with my feet being on the ground. I barely like to fly. I will drink until I fall asleep on a plane.
Know,
you hear me?
Them all inclusive.
That's what got me, dog. You know what I'm saying? When you tell me free alcohol, yeah. It's like,
yeah.
Dang, that's it how you get
though.
Niggas? Free alcohol?
Though.
All right, I'll go.
Yeah, I don't
and like,
know.
And you don't need your passport. You know, yeah. You can get off the boat in like a designated location, and you know you can't leave that location, but you don't need your passport when you with the cruise.
That's what I heard too.
I mean, you got your passport?
No.
I mean, we got our passport, you know. So.
Oh, okay.
But just, nah, you gotta get your passport.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
You've been invited to some of the trips.
I'll get my passport.
Yeah, I told her about DR. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But now on the Carnival Cruise, though, right? It said 60 people was on there brawling. It said 40 to 60 people, right? Uh-huh. And it all started over some cheating allegations, right? Which I don't think is allegations. I think it really happened. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Man's probably, you know what I'm saying? He said, babe, I'll be back.
Ooh.
He was gone for like 2 hours.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Came back. She's like, where you at? I was at the bar. Well, which one? I went to all of them. Well, the one with the captain. The captain be going to.
Right.
But as I said, it all started, man. You know what I'm saying? So I'm trying to envision, like, it had to be family members there. Like, a bunch of family members.
And he had to knock off at least 16 joints.
Damn.
You got to do the math, you know? I mean, say it's like, it's a couple. That's just two people in the brawl. You know, so at 16, that's only, what, 32 people? Nah, we just halfway there. So, yeah, it was family, too. But he had it, yeah. He had to knock off at least 16 joints.
God.
That's the only way I could see it making sense for 40 to 60 people getting involved, you know?
It's a threesome, though.
There was a threesome
involved? It was a threesome. That's how it started. Over a threesome. So, 16.
What? I mean, you can get them figures from a threesome? From four people?
Well, I mean, all right, so I'm talking about another solution. All right,
unless it was like a couple of family reunions, like you said. But other than that,
I can see a couple of family reunions. So I can see like a couple come, right? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And one of them insisted on bringing something back to the room. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? And then they did that. But then I guess he enjoyed what happened. You know what I'm saying? So he went and left wifey like, yo.
Oh, he sidebarred it. He took it to the side.
Yeah, like, he got more. You feel what I'm saying?
He got a one-on-one sesh.
You know what I mean? And then wifey probably found out. And they probably all there with the family, too. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
That's a big-ass family.
Yeah.
So that's two big-ass families. I mean, that's his friends associated, too. Mm. I don't even know that many people. I don't even know that much family.
I do.
And then you got alcohol involved.
Yeah, because it happened at the bar.
It's going to be like four of us fighting like 50 people. Like,
You know, it's crazy. I see somebody hitting the wrong person.
That's what I thought.
And then all of a sudden, like somebody hit me. I'm not even in the mix.
It's like somebody stepping on your brand new sneakers in the club. And that's how fights used to break out back in the day.
All your cousins got
to
jump in and shit.
Yeah. Now they see me swinging. What's going on? Yeah.
You don't even know why you fighting. You just swinging because your cousin is fighting and y'all drunk. What? Or your girl. It could be a friend's trip or whatever. Let me see one of my girls over there fighting. You think I ain't running up? No questions asked. And I'm tall. I'm reaching over all y'all bitches. Effect.
Is it a snowball effect?
It's a snowball effect. Yeah. You know I mean, it started with just, there's just four groups right here and shit, right? Then, yeah, I mean, somebody probably tried to break it up. And they got hit, too.
They got hit.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yup.
That's how it be. Somebody tried to break it up. Yeah. It's probably a white person.
Probably.
You know what I mean? Then their family got involved. You know what I'm saying? Next thing you know what I mean?
Those poor white folk, they got dogged. Because I'm assuming this is black folk. I'm sorry to say it, but
that's what I thought about. It was a couple white people in there.
Yeah, it was a couple. They tried to break the fight up.
it was folk in there, too, though. It was definitely folk in there.
You know what I mean? And how does security handle that? Like,
you don't.
They had to call the Coast Guards.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. They called the Coast Guards.
That's dope.
That's dope.
That's like them calling the fucking military and shit. Yeah.
But then again, if you think about it, they had to call them. Yeah, mm-hmm. Out
they
in the water,
the National Guards.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? On international territory.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Where did they say it was on the last leg of the tour or something like that?
Something like that.
Yeah. No, wait to the last leg though.
I know you done paid all that money, but nobody got arrested.
Oh, yeah, nobody arrested.
Well, shit, if it was the last leg, they got their money's worth.
Nobody got arrested, though. Nobody was charged.
That's
nothing.
What I'm saying. It was the
That's
last
love.
Leg of the tour.
That's love. You get to kick ass for free.
I mean, can they arrest them, though, on international waters?
Yeah.
Like, you can't really arrest them.
Nobody's safe. Yeah.
The Coast Guard can get you, I guess. Safe. That's why they called them. I don't know.
Nobody's safe.
I ain't never been outside of the I ain't never been in international waters and outside the nation.
Dang.
No.
Gotta get that passport.
I know.
You know what I'm saying?
I am.
I'm mad though. My daughter, off top, my daughter been to more places than me, and she got her passport. She got a passport for me. I was kind of mad about it. I signed off on it, but I'm mad.
Know that.
Yeah, so she had a passport since she was 8. Cause she was modeling and stuff. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Oh, that's why.
She been to Mexico. You know what I'm saying? Some southern hemisphere island. I don't know.
See, I was telling my daughter she got to get her passport. She's 16 now.
Oh, yeah, tell me that, John, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking to everybody. You need password.
I'd buy it when Michonne called me like that.
You know? Yeah. You know, it's crazy. My daughter, she don't really hit me up and be like, hey, Dad, you know what I mean? That's dead. That stopped at the, 11. You know what I'm saying? Now she hit me up. She don't even hit me. She'll send me a text message with an image of some sneakers that she want. Mm-hmm. Like, don't ask for them. Yeah. Just say, boom, here. And I'm like, oh, yeah, those fire. What, you want them or something? Yeah, can you get them? You know, I see what I can do. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to get them. You know what I mean? Unfortunately. Oh, they back. And they loud. You know what I mean? But nah, as far as... speaking of travels, though, so... I heard it's 40 cents to a dollar and DR are prostitutes.
No, not the prostitutes. The currency.
Oh, okay.
She said, she said it's 40 cents to a dollar. So $1 is like $2 there, I guess. Right? Something like that.
Wow. I mean, because, you know.
$1 here, like. I mean. Something like that.
80 cents.
Yeah,
you
but.
Can't get, you know.
We ain't worried about that 20 cent. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Yeah, 80 cents will be $2 there. So not even a whole dollar is $2 there.
Nah, so what you saying about the prostitute, though?
Oh.
You know what I'm saying?
We're just going to jump right in. All
wait,
right,
wait, hold on. You want to talk about Aruba first? Huh? What happened in Aruba?
Oh, go ahead, go ahead. Say, hell no, I want to hear about this. Okay, so NDR, I've been told that there are prostitutes that you can pretty much purchase for your entire duration of your trip. Or if you just want to, you know, want them for the night, you can switch it up. Get another one the next night, whatever.
The option. This is up, okay.
People, they do this though to feed their family. They'll have like 8 people living in their home, and they have to provide for all of those 8 people. So they will follow you back to your hotel room. If you don't invite them in when you come out the next morning, they on the floor asleep in front of your door, waiting for you to venture out for the next day.
That's thirsty.
Yes.
I guess it's hungry. Damn.
This story comes from somebody who went there and experienced this. So I'm like, what? This is crazy. And they have different prostitutes that you can rent.
Yeah, I'm
not. You can rent. So is there like an enterprise or Avis there, like of prostitutes?
I guess so.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you
they
just go in there,
outsiders. Uber hooker. They smell
like,
foreigners.
Don't I leave a deposit? Like, you know what I mean?
Door dick. Yeah. All
that. You don't want a little deposit.
But they do, though. It's a thing. And people really, they really do that. They'll go out, you know, have a guy's trip, leave their wives and kids at home, go mess with these prostitutes, and chill for a couple days before they come home so their balls are full again. That way that their wives don't know that they was over there smashing and doing everything else.
That's wild.
Yeah. And they take that money home and they feed their family.
I'm not paying for no coochie. I pay a chick to dance for me, though. And I do that.
To dance?
Yeah.
So you'll pay to dance, like, but you won't pay to smash.
Yeah.
See, I'm feeling myself. That came up perfect.
It did.
Alright, I'll pay for some coochie if it's somebody I'm already dealing with. Cause I don't know this.
Wait, hold on.
I'll pay for some coochie if it's somebody I'm dealing with. You know, somebody who I'm already smashing. You know, I might just come up like, yo, what can I get for $100? You know, just some shit like, I like doing shit like that.
That's not the same.
Well, exactly.
That's kind of entertaining, though. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Like, you already smashing her.
Make it rain on my joint. You know, like, oh, like dancing for me. I'm gonna tip you. You know, you keep that. You know, I might take a couple dollars back. But
that's totally different, though, because it's like
role play. You know what I mean? But
I don't see that. But okay, I don't know, because it's like when you become intimate with somebody. For me, it's like a role play. Unspoken contract type situation, you know what I mean? Like, even if okay, for example, y'all might not be in a relationship, but I ain't gonna go out here fucking with nobody else because
exclusive.
Like, that's just me. It's yeah, but I mean, you can still entertain other people, you can go on dates and do all that, but as far as being intimate, it's called an
exclusive contract.
Yeah, unspoken though, like, you know what I mean? Like, we didn't talk about it. It wasn't initiated, nothing like that.
Didn't communicate.
I mean, that's just exclusive. That's just how I look at it. So
I could be dealing with like 4 different chicks or whatever.
Oh yeah, but are you smashing all 4 of them?
That's what I'm saying. If I am,
that's not an option. Is what I'm saying. Like, that's how I look at it. I'm like, I'm only smashing one person.
I feel you.
You know, I'm not interested in that. I feel like I'm too old for that now. But so given that situation, it's totally different, because if that person reached out to me and was like, yo, I'm down for a second or whatever, or something, an emergency happened, can you send me Cash App, whatever, XYZ, yeah, I got you. Doesn't mean we boyfriend and girlfriend or have any type of label, but all right, I got you, because I'm we're on a different level, you know what I mean?
Oh nah, I was buying coochie.
But that's not buying coochie. That's what I'm saying. So that's different, because you have an intimate relationship with this person. Buying coochie is just straight, is what it is. You don't know this person. You probably never gonna see them again in life. You never gonna see them again. So you buying a coochie for the night, and then you going home. Y'all are going home separately, and you're never gonna speak to this person again. Once y'all part, even if y'all link up the next day, once you go home, you leave that island, she's gone. You're never going to see her again. That's my and coochie. So giving money to a shorty that you smashing is totally not, that's not the same thing.
Okay.
I feel what he's saying. He's saying role play. Like, he's been smashing her, you know what I'm saying, like, for days and days, and then all of a sudden one night he's like,
what you going to do for her? Put on a show for me. I'm going to take care of you.
Okay. But in the back of your mind, you know her. So it's you don't know these hussies.
Ain't no back in my mind, right?
Oh, okay.
We strangers. That. Yeah, we in a strip club.
Oh. But. Okay. Fact remains.
I used to have a pole in my living room.
Yeah, but you still know this person, though. In your heart of hearts, you still know that.
Hold on, wait. You said what?
You gonna put a pole up?
No, I said I used to have a pole in my living room.
I thought you said he was gonna put a pole up.
My kids would be swinging on it. I cover the house and my son swinging on the triple pole. I'm gonna have a problem. I'm not talking about the baby. I'm talking about the fucking 11-year-old. I'm gonna knock a nigga down. Hey, come on, you playing fireman? Get the fuck out of here. I'm not gonna set myself up like that.
Yo, he said the fireman. He playing fireman.
You playing P Valley, nigga.
Oh, that's my shit.
You watch that?
Nah. Yes.
Oh, we're gonna talk about that later.
Okay.
Yeah, we're gonna talk about that. Yeah, you know what I mean? That's a good show right there. We're gonna bring that up later, though.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? But you was telling me off mic, though. You said you knew somebody that actually purchased, though.
Yeah.
You talk about that, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. There's a group of guys who are, majority of them are married, that they take a vacation to DR and they pick up chicks. Prostitutes. They pick them up and they rent them out or whatever. It's like you go, it's a certain area that you go to, and I mean, they be all out in the open smashing. It's like Pandora's box over there, certain areas. And you can pretty much rent a hoe for the duration of your stay. That's what I'm saying.
I said that when first time Demi was on.
Yeah.
And the crazy joint.
I forget, but she was lit.
Yo, she was gone.
Like, she drank in a whole nother spirit.
She is her Instagram name or some shit like that. I don't remember her.
Okay, well, I don't want to talk about nobody. I don't know. But yeah, they rent these hoes. And they smut them out for the duration of their stay to their liking. And then, like I said, they wait and pause a couple days before they go home, so their wives don't know that they were doing some shady stuff. And this is from a very reliable source. And I'm just like, and one of the wives found out and left one of the husbands.
Like, immediately? Like, she found out immediately or she found out later?
She found out later.
Like,
because he had been doing it for years.
Oh.
Like, I don't know if they do it every year or every other year, but they go frequently. It's frequent enough. Okay.
Oh, she had to let that slide.
No!
That's the problem.
No.
Man was letting it slide.
No. Ew. No.
When I was in Aruba, I swear I talked about this. The dude who was like, he was like the host of one of the restaurants. It's actually like the buffet. You know, he see me in there. He was talking, hey, how you doing? You know, he's serving my drinks. So I go out the night, doing the nightlife thing. I'm out there by myself. So I'm ordering drinks and shit. I'm fucked up out there.
So you was outside of the resort?
Yeah.
Oh, you left the all exclusive?
It was like right across the street.
Oh, you brave soul, man.
Inclusive.
Okay. Yeah. I need variety. Okay. So it's like, yeah, this here, but it's like limited here. Mm. You know, it's like, ain't no parties popping off here. Mm. Now the joint we got we trying to get for DR, they got clubs and bars like that. They got actual nightlife on the resort.
On the one that's not in front of the water.
Yeah, the water right there though, but it's not on the water. Well, look, I mean, I told you to check them out though.
And I'm talking about night. I can't do it on the phone. I gotta be on a computer, dog. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying?
So yeah, I'm out, but it's like right across the street from the resort. And I see dude. I'm like, yo, is that dude? I don't want to be racist. Like, all these Arubas look the same, but Arubians.
Is that what they call
it? I don't know. I mean, but he's like, hey, yeah, you staying at the Marcello or whatever. I'm like, yeah. He's like, yeah, you here by yourself? So I'm like, yeah. He's like, oh, I got some girls, man. Like, so yeah, he like host by day. I mean, pimp by night. And like, yeah, he's like, yeah, you want, let me know where you want to go. Like, I'm thinking like, then I start Googling like the crime rate in Aruba, and it's like, it's actually kind of low. Maybe I do want to hit dude up.
Oh, Lord.
I thought about it for like 2 or 3 nights. I ain't do it though.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
You sure?
Nah, I definitely consider it though. I mean, like I said, I wasn't going to buy no coochie though, but it's like, all right, you got some joints to party with, all right. I pay for entertainment, but not.
But you won't pay for coochie.
No, I won't.
So what if you pay for the entertainment
and they give you
something
like a bonus?
That's
just
an incentive.
That's
yeah, it's a little bonus.
Is that kind of paying for it though?
The plot thickens.
And look, if I can find some loopholes and some coochie, I'm gonna take it. But
loopholes. Nah, that's wild. I'm definitely not leaving the resort though. You know what I mean?
Well, it's gonna depend on the setup. I'm gonna check the surrounding areas and I'll find out what's going on.
Nah, Google mapped it, Google Earthed it.
Yeah.
It looked nice. It looked good out here, you know what I'm saying? It's not a crime rate map. It wasn't in red, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, oh, I might be able to rent a scooter and go somewhere. Yo, they have dune buggies.
Oh.
I was on Expedia. No. Yeah, Expedia. And you know how it'd be like things you can do in the area?
Mm-hmm.
They got dune buggies, dog.
You gotta get the TripAdvisor app.
Is that what that one?
Yeah, see the TripAdvisor, it's like what you call it? It's like the Better Business Bureau for all these excursions and shit like that.
Oh, for the people that don't know, BBB, Better Business Bureau. It's a great place. If you you know what I mean? It's people that don't know.
That's
if you
how
ever
you
like
find out.
The business is legit or not, you know what I'm saying?
Like the motherfuckers I bought my Malibu from in Jersey,
They had an F rating.
BB was like, nah, don't go there. Oh. I ain't know
that
shit.
Straight said, nah.
I ain't know that.
Nah.
They had a rating of nah.
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 He said, nah. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
but TripAdvisor is like the BBB of the, you know, the traveling experiences and shit like that.
So, and you get real reviews and everything, you know what I'm saying? Google do too, but sometimes they be faking it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because I found the website where I'm trying to promote, what's it called? The Gemini Music Group.
Mm-hmm.
And the website said, we'll create, what's it called? We'll create reviews for you. And I'm like, what? That sounds fake.
Yeah, falsified?
Yeah, it. Like, you know what I mean? I don't want no fake reviews, you feel what I'm saying?
Right.
Give me the real Jones, you feel what I'm saying? So y'all pay more for that though. Mm. You know what I mean? But it's all good.
But now the TripAdvisor app, you could put your credit card on there and book through them. So it's legit. That way you don't gotta worry about paying for some suspect shit. You rent out somewhere in the jungle and get robbed.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, buddy.
So yeah, go through TripAdvisor.
I'm definitely trying to do that dune buggy, dog. I never rode one. You know what I'm saying? Like,
neither.
I rode like a, you know, a four wheeler and stuff. Dude. Yeah, but like actual dune buggy that goes into like the dunes and it's dirty and you gonna get dirty. Like, you know what I mean?
You don't want to say that for Vegas though, or for somewhere in the desert.
Nah, but they got the mud one though. Okay. It's not mud, but like it's you gonna get dirty.
Yeah, that sounds.
Nah, it can't be like Colorado though, where you would just follow.
Nah, that channels. Joint was corny, dog.
Yo.
I won't be able to knock out the one. I think the one in the desert though, in Las Vegas.
Yeah,
you can actually ghost them joints, like really like turn up, like if you might break something. I want that. You know what I mean? I'm trying to break something. You feel what I'm saying? So I know I got a good time.
I'm trying to sign the waiver and shit. Like if I die, it's on me. Like,
it's a note for me.
That's how you get some freedom right there. You got to sign your life away. Like go ahead, do you?
Yeah, and I'm getting my own doom.
Your own doom.
Yeah, own doom.
Okay.
Cause I wrote. It was similar to a doom, a little bit smaller, but taller. in the backwoods or whatever.
Polaris Jones or whatever.
I think that's what it was. In PA though, it had a 4-seater on. Yeah. My pops was driving, and I was like, "Yo, I never do that again."
Basically, like a quad with a roof.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying. Yeah. Pops was driving, like, and I was scared. I'm holding on to the joint, like, "Yo, you got to slow down." This joint about to flip, and he like living life on the edge. It don't matter what it is.
He ain't got nothing to lose.
You know what I'm saying? Like, he wanted to go skydiving before he passed. You know what I'm saying? Man was white water rapid and all that stuff. The wild water. I did it one time. I said, "I ain't doing this again." You know what I'm saying? I'll never do that again.
You still can't swim, right?
If my life depends, I'm going to swim. I'm going to stay afloat. You feel what I'm saying? I'm going to stay afloat. You feel what I'm saying?
You swim?
I can refrain from drowning.
Stay afloat.
I will dead man float if I have to. You hear me?
So, I can swim, but not enough to be like jumping off cliffs and shit.
Yeah,
like,
I'm not
that's
there.
That's what I went to PR for, though. To jump off a cliff.
Did you jump?
I jumped twice. 2.5 times, actually.
Wait, why half?
Exactly. I need to know about this half. How did you get the half?
They had the top point where you jump from. I jumped from there twice. Then they had like the little medium point where you use the swing. So it's like, all right, nah, I'm here to do this. I ain't about to half-ass it and just go to this medium joint. I'm going straight
to
the top.
You going all the way up.
So it's like, all right, I did the jump from the top twice. I guess I do the swing. So got the rope, got a grip on the rope, you know, I went to do it, foot slipped, held on for dear life.
My life would have flashed before my eyes. I would have lost it for
dear life, and just let go. So yeah, I didn't even get the jump, I didn't get the swing, I just ended up in the water.
Wait, hold up, so you didn't actually counts. Swing? Like,
I mean, I did, because I wasn't about to let go and fall on the fucking rocks. So.
Yeah, exactly. That's why
like I said, held on for dear life. Luckily, my upper body strength, you know, is proportioned to the rest of my body. So
you like looking down, like, I'm gonna clear these rocks first.
Nah, I just knew they was there. Like, before I jumped, I asked somebody, like, yo, how deep is the water here? And, call it, they was like, oh, you couldn't touch the bottom if you tried. To the most people, that's scary. Now, that's what the fuck I need to hear.
Yeah. I like my feet to touch the bottom, or I'm not going in.
I need to hear a number.
If I'm jumping,
12 feet, 15
nah.
feet.
I'm 6 feet, nah. And I'm 5'8", some change.
Dude told me, like, you couldn't touch the bottom if you tried. Mm-mm. Perfect. Sign me up. This means I'm like, I don't want to break shit when I hit the water. Suppose I dive in. I mean, I don't want to take the chance of hitting a rock.
But how you going to get back up? I just hold your breath in it. Oh, yeah. That's why.
But not enough to be jumping off cliffs. But I did it. Two and a half times.
I mean, technically, the way, like, even if you do dive into the water, you hold your breath, the air is going to automatically
bring back
up.
Yeah, push you back up.
Anyway.
You know how long that's going to take?
It's going to take a while, though.
You're going to be out of breath.
Right. I'm a little on the heavy side. All right? I don't got that much air in me.
Mm. My thing is, like, the flippers that be going in the water and stuff. Yeah. I'd be like, how do they do that? Because I got to go in my feet first. So I know to swim back up. Mm-hmm. I don't want to go in this way, like down, and not know where I'm at. Like, what direction do I swim in? You know what I mean?
Or like, I know how to dive too. Like, I was at the Y. I ain't do that shit in Puerto Rico though. I was scared of shit in Puerto Rico. It was like I ain't hesitate my first time up there. I was like, I looked around 3.5 seconds. I just jumped off, and shit. But made it to the top, and like backstroke to safety. Oof. And I don't know.
Did it hurt when you hit the water?
Nah. But when I finally got out of the water and I was like sitting there in safety, my heart was,
I bet.
It took like 10-15 minutes to get my shit right. Like, I made it back up to the top of shit before my shit was right. Like, I was a little more nervous the second time. But I did it anyway. And then I went through this shit all over again. Like,
yeah.
We ain't had no life vest. Because we ain't used TripAdvisor. Alright, so we ended up in somewhat of a shady situation at the top of a fucking mountain with just some old Puerto Rican dude with the key in his pocket to the locked gate, and he just charging like $2 for parking. That's awfully strange considering they was trying to charge $100 a head.
Man, I pulled off. I had the car. I dropped them off and dipped.
You hustling. It was smart though.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna be. I ain't mad at
and
him.
He tell you in a second. Oh no, I know. I know on the mountain. Yeah, you know I mean, it's a free. I just played for parking. I mean, it's suspect, but you got mm-hmm. this. You got a little good hustle here.
Yeah, you can get I mean, ain't no telling what else you.
Not on that mountain with no service.
Not
on that mountain with no service. Middle of the jungle behind a locked gate.
Mm.
Surrounded by Puerto Ricans.
Locked.
I mean,
locked gate.
I mean, some of them looked like me, but they knew I wasn't one of them.
Oh,
so.
Snap.
I don't want no smoke. I got this.
See, that's why I ask my travel, like, depending on what city it is, I always have that like jersey on or that like colors, you know what I'm saying, like PR.
Yo, you said that jersey.
Kill me with that shit.
Yo, I really went to Colorado. I had a Colorado Rockies jersey on. You know what I'm saying?
No, no, we went to New York. He pulled out the butters. He pulled out the hoodie with the vest. The almost skinny jeans.
The almost skinny jeans.
Yeah, a little bit of room.
a little bit of room, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, everywhere we go, you know what I'm saying?
He had some baggy skinny jeans. That's what it was.
You know what I mean? Miami, I had the whole Miami lay on, you feel what I'm saying? Hey, you know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna front. I'm trying to find a DR outfit, you feel what I'm saying?
Yo, I dress like a tourist. Like a touring pimp.
But a touring pimp.
Not yeah. like Eddie Murphy and Coming to America when they got all that New York shit.
No facts, that'd be me. That'd be me in like any location.
You got buttons and pins. Hats.
I got accessories and shit.
T-shirts, hoodies. Listen. Oh, no.
Like, got you. I just
stand out wherever I go and shit. It don't even be intentional. Shit just happens.
Nah, dog. When you come with the bodyguard outfit, you know what I'm saying? Nah, he be fresh every time I go out. He fresh. Like the shoes, they not sneakers. They shoes. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like he grown. Oh, you know what I mean?
I just started buying sneakers for real.
Me, I come out like a young boy, you feel what I'm saying? Jordan's on, you feel what I'm saying?
Hey, you see me today. You came in was like, whoa, what you got on?
Oh, yeah, comment AI, yo, where you get them joints from? You know what I mean? But now you come out with the bodyguard gear, you know what I'm saying? The suit, the whole suit be fresh. I'm be like, yo, this nigga, I'm standing next to this nigga. Yeah, don't think I got money, you know what I'm saying?
Should I play security for real? I don't give a fuck. Nah, we was in New York, though. He had on his New York get up and shit. And I'm, you know, I got on my attire and shit. I'm like, yo, I look like your older brother who made it out of the hood, but I came back to visit you and shit.
Oh, shit.
That's how that shit looked. Hey, you just showed me the old hood and shit.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, yeah
that's where you used to post up at.
He's still over there. Yeah, I mean, nah, man.
Greasy old pizza shop ain't changed, you feel what I'm saying? Papi, look who home.
The Gemini Music Group.